Yo, 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 yo.
What's going on, everybody? It's Thursday, April 17th. You're watching StrongIsland.com, listening to Into Divine.
This is Kenny Orlando.
And I'm Misophonic.
We are here to present to you tonight a whole lineup of a bunch of music, all original, coming down with some videos. Exclusive interview with DJ Clay from Detroit off of Psychopathic Records. I hope you guys like that, you know.
And an exclusive premiere of an unreleased track produced by Misophonic, myself, by DJ Clay, called When It Rains, which will be airing later tonight after, like Kenny said, a bunch of new music, a bunch of new beats.
Mad and, hits.
Yeah, man. So what do you say we get into that DJ Clay interview to start things off?
DJ Clay, and you are listening to Into Divine on StrongIslandRadio.com. I'm DJ Clay. The best way to explain me is versatility. You know, I grew up around music. I mean, just like everybody else did, but it was a little different for me. I was more into how the music was made, you know, rather than just listening to it or hooping something was banging. I was more interested in how was all this shit made. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, what made this sound so fresh? Why do I like this song so much? And what's weird for me is when I hear, as a producer, when I hear a song, the beat is the first thing that I hear. I'm hearing the words, the lyrics, you know, I'm hearing the lyrics, but I'm not listening, at least the first time around. I'm more into, like, okay, listen to this beat. Like, this bitch is sweet, this bitch is sweet. I like it, you know, a lot of beats inspire me, you know. Also, you know, DJ Clay, the name speaks for itself. I'm a DJ, you know. It all kind of came hand in hand, you know, DJ, producing, rapping. I was 11 years old. I was 11 years old recording mixtapes off of a tape deck. Now, there's a few people out there, and maybe more than a few, I don't know. I don't know too many cats that did it myself, but I used to do it. When I was 11, my uncle had a Kenwood, you know, tape deck, a dual tape deck. And I also had a dual tape deck at home. But he had a better car. I had some off-brand Radio Shack fucking, you know, piece of shit. So every time I'd go over my uncle's house, I would love it because I would take songs that I liked and I would, you know, dub them onto the blank tape on the right side, you know, play it on the left side, dub it on the right side. And then the only difference about my uncle, besides it being name brand, and that's what helped a lot, was the pause. It was seamless, you know. So, say the song was playing, and then it was ready to come to the part where I was ready to mix the next song, I would hit pause on both decks real fast, and it would seamlessly do it. See, now on the tape deck that I had at home when I did that, and then when it was all said and done, in the playback, you would hear all those little clicks. You would hear those pauses in between tracks. So eventually, he ended up giving me that tape deck, and I was going wild on it. But I wasn't making mixtapes, putting them out. I mean, I was an 11-year-old kid. You know, I come from a background to where, you know, all my uncles and stuff, they used to deal with dope, so they had a lot of fresh shit, like boats. Like, we'd go out the weekends, we'd go up on their boats and stuff. So basically, I'd make mixtapes, and we'd bang them on the boats, you know? Like, all my uncles' friends used to love them. They would love them, you know? And that's how I really got into the, you know, mixing and the DJing, and then of course hand in hand, after you make your first beat and make your first mixtape and all that, then the way my brain was working was like, I'm pretty sure I can rap. I'm pretty sure I can rhyme. That was my mentality when I was young. You know, so I gave it a try by the time I was like 13. And that was the same time I got my turntable. My first set of real turntables. I could do real mixes, matching, you know, BPMs and everything like that. So rapping came hand in hand after I made a beat, because I didn't know nobody that rapped at that age. So all I knew was the cassette tapes and records that I had, you know, all the rappers that I had on cassette tapes from, like, you know, old everything. You know, a lot of freestyle. In Detroit, there's a lot of freestyle music, you know, like Stevie B remixed to a hubby and stuff like that, Little Debbie and Raquel. And that wasn't really rap, you know, but that was the stuff that I was mixing. And I'd get a hold of some instrumentals, and I would just write my own rap, sit back and write my own rap. And, you know, it's pretty much been history since then. I haven't stopped. So, I mean, that's who DJ Clay is. My approach on the way I make beats and everything is a combination of both. You know, it gets technical when it comes down to the final mix and the final sound of everything, but it starts off spiritual. It starts off something that I feel, something that I hear inside of my head, or something that I feel inside of my soul, and I hit a drum machine or a keyboard, whatever's in front of me. You know, whatever I start off making the beat with, you know, it's usually more spiritual, coming straight from the head, something that I'm it might be something that I've been hearing in my head for, you know, 4 or 5 days, or it might be something that just popped in my head, and if I'm around some equipment at the moment, I'll just start going on it. Even if I don't finish it right away, I got it started already, at least. You know, when I come back, that the soul comes back to it, because I hear it and I'm like, okay, that's what it's missing. So that's when it gets a little technical. And then, you know, when I add missing pieces and then I feel like it's finished, then it gets real technical when I start getting down to my mix of everything. So yeah, it's a little bit of both, you know, it's spiritual and technical, you know. Words of wisdom and advice that I have to any aspiring rapper, producer, DJ is dedicate yourself or don't fucking do it at all. Dedicate yourself. Practice. But when people say practice makes perfect, that ain't no bullshit. You know what I'm saying? You know, stay practicing. Stay warm. Never let yourself get cold. If you're a lazy motherfucker and you got talent but you're not using it, then just give it up. And I'm not saying that in an asshole type of way, but that's just the hard truth. Because if you don't grind hard in this game, you will be forgotten about really, really quick. My favorite piece of equipment to use to produce beats is whatever's in front of me at the time. You know, if it has a decent quality sound, a great quality sound, sometimes shitty sounds sound awesome in certain beats. But it's basically whatever in front of me at the time. Currently, I'm using the machine, you know, and I also use Pro Tools, you know, with the MIDI. It's my keyboard. I ping pong back and forth from all that. The Reason, back in the day, I had, before Pro Tools, I had Cakewalk and Fruity Loops. Before Fruity Loops was actually fresh, when Fruity Loops was like from the year, back time and shit, but I did use it. And even before that, the PlayStation Music Generator. The very first one from the first PlayStation. So, I mean, amazing basically anything I can get my hands on that's in front of me at the time. If I'm at somebody else's studio where they got an old MPC, I'll play around with it, and if something sweet comes out of it, then we'll run with it. Currently, what's sitting in my studio, though, is the trigger finger, a couple MIDI keyboards, turntables, the machine, and I still have rings on my computer. Sometimes, you know, I've got to go back to the reason for certain things, you know? I got involved with Psychopathic really young, even though a lot of the heads up at Psychopathic didn't know that I was around doing things. When I was 16, 17 years old, DJing local Psychopathic events around here in Detroit, you know, at clubs in downtown Detroit, you know, I didn't know ICP. I didn't know Lyron J or Shaggy 2, though. The only person that I knew was, and I still didn't know him, you know, but I just knew him because he was handing me money. And it was two people. One person was Alex Abbott, the other person was Jump Steady. You know, and it was because I was the DJ at the end of the night. They broke me off the money for DJ and the event. And that was basically it. When I was really young, and the Rude Boy is the person that I knew from, because he's from the same neighborhood as me. He's from Southwest Detroit. And I knew him from DJing a party. I DJed one of his relatives' backyard parties at like 15 or 16, 15 years old, something like that. I was real young, had some shitty turntables, but the party was cracking. I was doing the job, and you know, the Rude Boy DJs every now and then himself too, you know, so, you know, he respected that, and he seemed this young ass little kid spinning at the party, just getting it cracking. And he approached me, asked me how old I was, asked me my name and everything. And from then on, we had a mutual friend, which is one of my best friends to date, you know what I'm saying, my boy Jose. And that's how I was able to keep in contact with the Rude Boy. And so every time the Rude Boy needed some sort of DJ for a party he was throwing or an event that a Psychopathic might have been throwing, he would reach out to my boy Jose, and then my boy would call me, and then we just set it up. And I'd go out, and I'd spin, you know, and as years passed, you know, I was 22 when I got the legit phone call from the Rude Boy, you know, asking if I wanted to go out on tour with Shaggy Tudo for his Fuck the Fuck Off tour. And I was like, yeah, sure, man, of course, you know, let's do it, you know. I wasn't worried about pay or anything like that at the time. You know, I was like, hell yeah, you know, why not? It's a no-brainer. I mean, why would you say no to a nationwide tour to go DJ for somebody like Shaggy 2, though, from ICP? You know, so I did that, and I thought it was a one-time gig. You know, I thought it was a one-time gig. I thought I was going to go out on that tour and come back home and, you know, go back to work doing what I was doing, you know, and me and Shaggy ended up getting close as homies, you know, and, you know, we kept in contact after that tour on some what's up shit, and then I got a phone call from Shaggy asking if I wanted to go out and do ICP DJ on a Halloween tour, so of course I said yeah, and then so on and so forth. It led from the Halloween tour to us, them asking me if I wanted to be part of the studio squad for making the record The Tempest. So, you know, we had a small studio squad, we made The Tempest, and then we went out on The Tempest tour. And around that time, while we were out on The Tempest tour, you know, I remember asking people on the aside and asking me if I wanted to be exclusively their DJ for all their live shows. And, you know, that's something that I did not expect at all. So I was like, fuck yeah, man. I mean, you know, by that time, we all had a relationship as far as homies and everything like that. So we were all cool. I was like, fuck yeah, man, let's do this. I mean, let's rock some shit, you know? And, you know, pretty much in history from then on, you know, I've just been doing it ever since. And now, you know, currently to this day, I'm still in my lane, still doing what I love to do, you know, producing, DJing, touring, you know, rapping, all that stuff. When did AR come about, and where's it going? What's it doing right now? AR came about before I was with Psychopathic. You know, I started my own label with my boy Jose that I mentioned before, and you know, we invested into studio equipment. We built our own studio because I knew my way around the studio, so we just you know, pretty much hustled it out, stacked up some money, and went out and bought some gear. After we bought gear, I was just, you know, I was in my zone. I had everything I needed. I had my, you know, I had my recording set up, everything, my setup for production. Me and him just went and cashed out at Guitar Center. You know, starting off just cashing out at Guitar Center, and then every week or every other week, we might go buy something new or take something back that we didn't need and buy something else new that we did need. And it started off like that, you know, and it was before I even got that phone call from the Rude Boy to come DJ for Shake and Tudo on the Fuck the Fuck Off tour. And it's been going strong ever since. And it's starting to turn into a movement because, you know, of just a few years in, not even a few, just a couple years in, after we legitimately had that stamp, that we knew what we were doing as far as a record label, as far as just, well, actually I can say, at first we didn't know what we were doing. You know, we were young, we were really young. But once we got to that point where we knew what we were doing, we were just renting out studio time. And a group of cats came through, and there was one dude that stuck out in particular to me and Jose, and we pulled him to the side and was like, yo, man, you know, you're the shit, you know. And at that time, I was a cocky little motherfucker at that time, to where I thought I was the only one that was the shit. But, I, you know, when I heard this dude, I was like, yo, man, this dude's the truth, you know, he can spit, he sounds great. I mean, he's a great rapper, and that was Bales. So we put Bales as the front man for AR as far as top artist on AR Entertainment. And we did pick up another artist. We ended up dropping him because he couldn't carry his own weight. And not only that, we were investing money into him. And, I mean, basically, he wasn't selling records. You know, we pressed up like 1,000 mixtapes, and, you know, professionally pressed up 1,000 mixtapes and sold like 30 of them. So he got the cut, to where Bell, his mixtapes were flying out the door. You know, people were loving his shit, and now it's turning into a movement to where if you come out Southwest Detroit, at least right now, I mean, you're likely to see people wearing the AR logo, you know, on t-shirts, on hoodies, on jackets, on hats, stuff like that. And so it's becoming a movement now. More people are starting to recognize it, you know, as that's what I was doing before, you know. And I'm just still working with both, you know, Psychopathic AR is my, you know, AR is my heart, because it's something that I personally started my, you know, myself with my partner, and a Circle Classics is my heart, because they put me in the limelight real tough, you know, and so it's basically still moving like that, you know, and we're currently working on a new project for Bale and a new project for me. And we're also working on a collabo project. And that's some news right there that don't know, nobody knows.
Yep, we're back. That was an exclusive DJ Clay interview that we had right there.
A little long, but, like, he has so much to say, man. He's done so much work, and, like, just from where we come from, like, as far as, like, personally between me and him, like, this is someone that we've always, like, strived to, like, be like, you know? He's always been an idol of ours, like, DJ Clay, and the fact that we got to do this interview was very, like, you know, touching to us, so we're glad that we got to present this to you.
Yeah, it was dope. He's the big homie. Definitely check out his latest in-store release, which is A World Upside Down. And yeah, just look into the homie DJ Clay. Later we're going to be premiering an unreleased song that I produced with the homie. And for right now, we got some new beats and some new music to get into.
Right now we're going to play Monkeys in Space, produced and, by Misophonic.
And City of Gold, also produced by Misophonic.
You already know.
Yeah, hope you can enjoy these this flavor for your ears. Let's get into it.
replayed this record frequently. This record as frequently as possible.
That was City of Gold and Monkeys in Space, some new beats, some new music. Right now we're going to take a short interlude, a short break. We're going to play some commercials and interludes. Stay tuned and we'll be back very shortly.
Very shortly.
We're back.
That was Telekinetic by Misophonic. That was off of Chocolate Milk, the B tape you could find on
Bandcamp.
I was about to say B-Port.
You could download Chocolate Milk for free at Bandcamp. That's one of my first instrumental album projects out, you know.
If you like Dilla, you know, check out Misophonic, man. Like, it's one of those tapes you could put in and rock out to and vibe out to all the way through, no problem.
And next, we got a little snippet of some new music, a new beat.
Colored Water.
With some visuals by my homie to the left of me.
Yeah, it's some visual beat, really, you know, just something to keep you enticed.
Keep you interested, occupied, you know, instilled. Paying attention. Yeah, definitely. So, and then we got something very special coming after that, but first, let's get into that Color Water. Yo.
And now the exclusive world premiere of
When It Rains by DJ Clay,
produced by Misophonic.
This is the exclusive world premiere.
You will unreleased. Not see it for a few months. Right now, you get a quick little preview of some dope music.
So let's not waste any more time and let's jump right into that.
When you walk into the ring, the number one heavyweight of the world, you'll be ready.
Riding in them new cars, when Marvin Gaye dropped the record Midnight Love, before he got gunned down by his own blood. I guess shit was just different back then. It was cool to see the dishes in the kitchen. It ain't cool though when moms gets hooked. Pops corner too, and that's the way it works. I don't know how the fam maintained, but a few years later, mama was laid. The doc said that she couldn't have kids, but then 8 months later, there I is, yo. I hope I have an angel on my shoulder, cause when times get rough, it only gets colder. And this is why I don't cry, cause God does it for me when it rains outside. And this is why I don't cry, cause God does it for me when it rains outside. And this is why we don't cry, cause God does it for us when it rains outside. Why we don't cry, cause God does it for us when it rains outside. It was a summer night when Dre got shot, a gang initiation down at Patton Park. Before wearing rags was a trend, when colors wrapped sets and didn't match tens. I was only 10 when I started losing friends. Everything around me I couldn't comprehend. Finding out what type of world you living in will change your mind state and have you living on the whim. I thought the 90s was the shit. My uncle's building houses out of bricks, off of bricks. But shit don't last. Black Raid mask, unmarked cars all up on my grandma's grass. It's like when you're up, you don't see the ground. Don't fall from the top, it's a long way down. Live by the gun, then you die by it too. So I'm just looking for the one that's gonna try to shoot me. And this is why I don't cry, cause God does it for me when it rains outside. And this is why I don't cry, God does it for me when it rains outside. And this is why we don't cry, cause God does it for us when it rains outside. And this
Oh yeah.
That was When It Rains by the big homie DJ Clay, produced by myself, Misophonic.
Dopeness, dank, nasty, down with the Dow, all about that. So sick.
Yeah, man, that's the jam. You'll be hearing a lot more of that soon when it's released officially. You know, that's the exclusive.
It's going to be all over Facebook, man.
The exclusive listen, you know, here on StrongIsland.com. For everyone tuned in right now, you know, Divine 9 Records and Into Divine. That was the exclusive listen, you know, for the people out there.
How'd you feel when Clay was like, yo, I'm using it?
You know, I wanted to hear it, you know what I mean? I've produced for some people, so, like, it's at the point where I'm not really him saying that's cool, but it's more like, you know, it's all for me, it's about the work. Let's put in the work. I want to hear the product. Yeah. And, you know, I feel like he's the same way, you know,
so
it was a mutual meeting on that as far as, you know, let's get this work done, you know what I mean? And it is what it is, you know, it's definitely a great feeling, like you said earlier, as somebody we look up to and, you know, inspired us growing up to be able to connect with him and have him respect my work and work with me nonetheless mutually as a peer.
Definitely, you know, that's, and that's for anybody else out there. Your dreams do come true, man. You just got to work for them.
Just stay persistent, man. But we got another commercial break to get into really quick before we wrap things up tonight with some more new music after it. So how about we go ahead and get into this little commercial break. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. And we got another exclusive brand new instrumental that we're playing here live on StrongIsland.com. Stay tuned.
Frequently as possible.
CEO of StrongIsland.com and Strong Island Radio and Television. I'd like to invite everybody to come down one Saturday and check out the new broadcast studio. See how we run our shows every night during the week on Strong Island Radio and Television. And you can come check out the store we got going on. We got a few t-shirts and mouse pads, puzzles, mugs, all sorts of cool things, hats and stuff like that. So like I said, come down one Saturday from 12 to 6. Come check us out. See where it all happens. And maybe pick up a little souvenir for the way home. All right, cool. Peace.
Now we're gonna get into Peaches and Plums,
which is another new exclusive instrumental
off the Hot Coffee beat tape, soon to be out.
Yeah, soon to be released. That collective Hot Coffee, you could pick it up soon at Bandcamp, just like Chocolate Milk.
Progressively, everything is just getting so much natural and organic, and the energy flow is just so beautiful, man. Like, you can't help but listen to it, you know.
So let's get into that Peaches and Plums joint,
produced by Misophonic.
When I make my music, you know what I'm saying, I want people to feel what I feel. I want them to feel that energy that I, whatever it was. Yeah, that's all it is, because I make it straight from the heart. So it's like, to be taken for anything else is crazy.
Thank you.
Divine Nine Records, baby.
Yeah, we're back. That was Peaches and Plums, and another new sound instrumental off the collective of Hot Coffee.
Yo, on Divine Nine Records, talking about Divine Nine Records, we just got some hoodies in, man, and they are beautiful.
And stickers. Beautiful. We got stickers, too.
Yo, follow us on Instagram. We're going to be doing mad giveaways. Mad giveaways. We don't care where you are. You could be in Malaysia. You could be in Indonesia. You could be in your freezer. It don't matter.
Absolutely. Hit us up at Misophonic _era, at KBoogz, KAYBOOGZZ. And hit us up. We got those free stickers, and we also got hoodies. Divine9records.com being updated, being completely revamped soon within the next 2 weeks. Completely new design, photos, updates, everything. Shows, you know, more into Divine shows. Beat updates, song updates, produced by updates. So definitely check into Divine9records.com. Keep checking into StrongIsland.com. Come down here on Saturdays. Get a shirt. You know, we're going to be doing some contests and giveaways for Strong Island merch as well as D9.
Definitely, definitely, definitely. And if you see any stickers around and you take pictures of them, direct message us on Instagram and we got you with some more stickers for yourself.
Or tag us. You know, we got our street team out there slapping them up. It's already in effect. The movement is already happening out in the streets.
For sure.
Join it. If you see it happening, take pictures, document it, tag us on Instagram or Twitter, any social media outlet, and we'll give you more stickers to go out and slap yourself, or we'll give you some free merch, a hoodie, or maybe we'll just give you a CD of some good definitely music to bump in the ride. We got you. Divine9records.com. And anything else you want to say to the people before we wrap it up here?
Divine Nine Records.
2014, 2015, to infinity and beyond. Divine Nine Records. Stay tuned. Check out Divine9records.com. Once again, can't say it enough times. And stay tuned to StrongIsland.com. Check out all the shows going on here. And keep it real. Keep it hip hop.
Yo, for sure. Straight out of Long Island. Straight out of New York. The East Coast. Birthplace of hip hop. You know, I'm trying to keep it real. Bring it back for sure.
I'm Misophonic.
I am Kenny Orlando.
This has been Into Divine on StrongIsland.com. Stay tuned next week. Peace.